Hey, welcome again to another playthrough video, because I'm bored as hell and I got nothing better to do. This is Ninja Gaiden Shadow. A little bit of a history to this game. This wasn't originally supposed to be... Hold up, I need to fix something. I noticed my screen is blown. Well, that's correct. Sorry. Okay, anyway, this is an actual game that was released on the Gameboy in 1990 or 91. It was supposed to be, get this, Shadow of the Ninja for the Gameboy. It was supposed to be the port. But Tecmo bought the rights to it and decided to make it a Ninja Gaiden game. I don't know why. I don't know the reasoning behind that. Because Ninja Gaiden Shadow is a very weak form of Ninja Gaiden. Okay, we've seen the story. We don't really... It's basically about the schmuck from the Shadow of the Ninja game causing havoc, and Ninja Ryu Hayabusa has to stop. Whatever. Look it up if you want to know the story. The plot's not important. What's important is the gameplay. And how does it play? Well, it plays quite well. The music, I don't think, was changed in the game, at least some of the tracks, because this is very Shadow of the Ninja sounding. So yeah, this was supposed to be Shadow of the Ninja at one point, and that would have been cool, because Shadow Ninja has to be one of my favorite Shadow games on the NES, next to the Ninja Gaiden trilogy. I'm not saying Tecmo's bad for buying the rights and changing it into Ninja Gaiden. I just don't think it should bear the Ninja Gaiden name, as it barely plays like a Ninja Gaiden title. You can't flip off walls. The only thing you have is that grappling hook that I just used a second ago. I mean, that's not what Ninja Gaiden is. Ninja Gaiden is flipping on walls, doing crazy shit, and super hard difficulty. Now, this game doesn't have hard difficulty. It's rather easy. There are some parts that I kind of fuck up at, but that's only because I'm stupid. I'm not gonna lie. I don't have what you call high self-esteem, but that's besides the point. Twitch isn't about self-esteem or self-improvement. It's about games, right? That's what I'm here to do. Alright, here's the first boss. He's a pushover. The only magic you have from Ninja Gaiden here is this. Yeah, whoopee flippin' do, right? It comes in handy on, I think, the next boss, where the next boss is like in a midget. I'm serious. You'll see it. I do a lousy impression, so if it ever annoys you, just tell me to stop, and I pretty much will. The only thing about this boss that's annoying is how many hits it takes to kill. I mean, a boss of this caliber is usually dead by now. There we go. Now, on my channel on YouTube, I did post a very crude but true video of me beating the boss. And the reason why I thought of doing this on Twitch is this way I can show the game, and you can actually see it. Instead of just seeing a really shitty camera showing the footage. The funny thing, I wasn't intending to, you know, post that on YouTube. Otherwise, it would have been a better angle, at least. Or I would have done it on an emulator like I'm doing right now. I just wanted to show the Super Game Boy in action and whatnot. I said, fuck it, I'll post it on YouTube. Of course, I don't really post there anymore. I have a lot of enemies on YouTube. And people can hate me on YouTube if they want. I mean, it's their choice. I'm not asking for friends, but if people want to be my friend, hey, I'll be your friend too. We can be cool. It's one of the reasons why I stopped making videos on YouTube. Because I thought, you know, it'd be nice to do something that I enjoy doing. And I kind of got bored of the whole vlogging thing, and there was really nothing else I could do. I don't have, you know, video-making skills or anything. I just put on the camera, talk some shit, leave it at that. That's all it was. But now there's so much of that, my presence is pretty much moot now on YouTube. Legacy lives on, though, and I'm sure my legacy will live on for a long time. Some of the shit I said was just out there, but it was funny. At least I still watch my old videos and crack up, because it's funny. But some people just, I guess, don't have a sense of humor anymore. That's unfortunate for them. Because having a sense of humor is important. I forgot how to get it. Oh, well, I know how to get it, it's just, do I want it? Those fire guys suck. I don't even know what's over there. You know what? Just for the sake of the stream, let's do it. Shouldn't have. It wasn't that hard to hit. I'm not doing a speedrun or anything, I'm just playing the game and playing through it. So as you can see, it's a very simple, simple game. It's not hard. I mean, it can get a little irritating here and there. It's not exactly hard. It's pretty easy. Well, it'd be fun to play if you're on a road trip. I mean, not in today's world, unfortunately. Everyone in today's world's all, yeah, I played my Android tablet. I'm guilty of this, too, because I fucking love my Nexus 7. And my wife loves her Asus Transformer, so... Something. I don't like her interface sucks. I don't like it because I like how you can combine the icons of different apps on the Nexus 7. That was given to me as a gift too, and I know she doesn't watch my streams, but thank you, Mama Cher. I appreciate it. That was the greatest thing anyone's ever given me. I'm serious about that. I love that tablet. I use it for a lot of shit. It's fun to play with. It's got some neat games I can download for it as well. But I don't necessarily agree about the mobile market taking over all handheld devices. I still think the 3DS is still the best handheld that's been grace upon us for the longest time. I mean, 3DS, because the thing about 3DS is it actually capitalizes on the DS, and, you know, you're taking that same idea and expanding it, which is what Nintendo should do with all their stuff. But they tried to with the Wii, but it just didn't work out, because, well, the Wii kind of burned itself near the end of its cycle. Alright, this boss can be annoying. Like I say, it looks like put the job do it now. Get off my you fucking dick. This is why this boss annoys the shit out of me. I don't know if I'll beat him on this life. Should have seen that happen, or coming. Alright, this time I'm not going to rely on my fire wheels, because as you can see, the fire wheel is weak. This boss is irritating shit. He's not as bad as... Well, actually, yeah, he is. He's as bad as the next boss. This little thing is pissing me off, though. Have any of you played the original Castlevania, where you fight the Flea Man versus the Frankenstein monster? The Frankenstein's easy. It's that Flea Man that pisses you off. This pretty much has that same stigma with it. Yep, I could have seen that coming. Get off my leg, you fucking leg humper. You know, you might as well be a fucking dog. Hey, you can die now? How many times have I hit this cocksucker? At least 20? He's harder than the last boss. In that regard. Thank God this game on the timeline. There. Ah. Took long enough to die. Thick dish. Yeah, you and little Arnold go in now. Long. Yep, here's a Ninja Gaiden tune you all should be familiar with. You play this game on a Super Game Boy, that flame color, or that flamethrower color, is purple. It's like, yeah, it's the purple flame of sexiness. I think it looks retarded. That's just my opinion. See, if this was a Ninja Gaiden game, you'd probably just flip up the fucking wall. But instead, oh, let's go ahead and use a grappling hook. So, I mean, it's so gay. Anyway. I'm sure Tecmo has its reasons to make a Ninja Gaiden Shadow. Why they bought Ninjao the Ninja. I would like to know the reasoning behind it. Or they're just like, oh, look. Were they just like, hey, look, let's go ahead and buy the game, and then we'll call it Ninja Gaiden Shadow, and no one will notice. Apparently, after that was released, it was pretty much known right after that. Shit, that was a bad idea. Bad idea, come on. Shit! Bad idea, I should have waited. See, that's the problem with having lack of patience. That's why they say waiting or having patience is virtue. Well, fuck patience. I don't have any. I have the same amount of patience as a spider when a fly meets its web. Okay, fuck that. Moving back. I'll wait for the next round. There we go. See, that works a lot better, doesn't it? But still revolves around waiting. Waiting sucks! You know, when you're a kid and you wait for Christmas, like, Christmas is what? Roughly about 20 days. And then when you're an adult, you don't give a shit about Christmas. I don't give a shit about Christmas. If I was a kid right now, I'd be having anxiety up the ass because I would want Christmas to come. It's like, oh, come on, Christmas. I wonder if I'm going to get that game I wanted. Or I hope I get those pants I wanted from the store. I mean, there was a lot of reasons to want Christmas when you're a kid. But then when you get older, Christmas sucks. I don't decorate. I don't put up a tree. Why? Because it's pointless. Like, oh, but it's pretty. Yeah, pretty as what? Dog shit covered in ice cream? So when you're an adult, Christmas sucks, and they're like, oh, but it's for kids. It shouldn't just be for kids. It should be for adults as well. What happened in this country? this country is so obsessed with children now, it's almost borderline pedophilia. I'm serious. I know that is such asinine statement I just made, but if you think about it, it's kind of true. I don't care for children, and some people who actually see my vlogs know this. This guy can be irritating at times. But if you do what I do here, he's not so bad. I kind of see him as M. Bison with a gun. Oh, sneaky! I never thought I would see an 8-bit douchebag actually be that sneaky. So that's pretty cool, I guess. Come on, shoot up, because I know you want to. See, so he's a pushover if you do this. It's not a hard pattern to learn. You eventually learn if you're up there, he's going to aim up at you. And he's done. Two more stages, the next stage is actually a headache, and the final stage is just as bad, so. This game has infinite continues, so we'll be okay. That's why it's a playthrough and not a how far can I get. I've been trying to do the how far can I get on the other channel, on the Twitch channel. The Clusterfuck channel. Because people like that series. So, I try to give it some. This tune's actually really catchy. And seriously, why does Ryu Hayabusa have to be underwater? Do they have an underwater plane? He's like, I must take it down! Got these overly happy douchebags with the Chinese stars. I'm sorry, this is catchy. Sometimes I just hum video game music when it's catchy. And if I remember, this part's actually kind of annoying. What made the Gameboy just amazing, in my opinion, is the fact that it's a miniature NES. Oh yeah, now I remember this part. Okay, I hate this. Haha, bitch. And in my mind, you can't go wrong with a miniature NES. You just can't. It's epic. It's almost as epic as getting a laser beam up your ass. And why is enemies repeating? Said this is annoying. And like the shield wielders are annoying. They're just like, yeah, I'll just show you my shield and then you can kill me as soon as I put it back. You fucking cocksucker. Here, have a flame. That was some bullshit. I had like little to no place to run. This is probably where I get my ass killed. Oh, I guess I'm wrong. This goes to show how many times I've played this game. I don't even remember the fucking level layouts as much. Oh, here this part sucks. This is like Castlevania Adventure all over again. On stage 3. really have to haul ass here, and I'm dead. Fan-flipping-tastic. Alright, this is my last go on this particular part. I might have to do the stage again. Those power-ups, but unfortunately I had no choice in the matter there. Right. I don't remember if this douchebag is hard or not. Right, he's fairly easy. If I play it right, I'll beat him. Gotta love that fucking hairstyle. Sexy. He was pretty much a pushover. I thought he was going to be worse than that, to be honest. But no, he actually turned out to be, easy. Alright, final stage, here we come. To the anti-climax of this game. Because I'll be honest, it's not all that climactic. There's another familiar tune to all you Ninja Gaiden fans of old. I don't have any much commentary right now. I'm just enjoying the music, you know. No one's watching me anyway. I forgot about the lasers, shit. It's classic Ninja Gaiden theme. I get it. Gaiden, Scott, not Gaiden. If it was Gaiden, it would be EI, not AI. Trying to learn as much Japanese as I can. I'm probably gonna die here. It'd probably be best anyway, but I wanted to try and see if I can get far in this stage. It is a relatively long stage because it is the final stage of the game, so. Come on, shoot. Alright, it's for the best, so that way I can get my three lives back. Now, if I was a kid, this screen would have gave me nightmares. Anything that has a game over in a scary face frightens the shit out of me when I was a kid. And today, it's not as scary, but it still gives me a little bit of the eebie-jeebies. not gonna lie. You know, things from your childhood, sometimes you get over and sometimes you don't. I think what's worse is Ganon from Zelda 2, though, that laugh at you. Oh my god, that gave me nightmares for fucking years. I'm serious. I had nightmares about him until I was about 11, 12 years old, and I played the game when I was 5 or 6, and it gave me nightmares all that night. I couldn't sleep. It's like, it was one of those things that I kind of regretted playing. But as time grew on and I got over that fear, I just got mad instead of scared at him, and they're like, shut the fuck up, Ganon, you dork. Now, as it stands, that's my favorite Zelda game of the Aether era. It's even better as Link's Awakening. Everyone's like, oh, Zelda is better in its overhead format. Suck my dick. That's not true. And thanks to you, we will never have a game like Zelda 2 again. And that saddens me. Because I can just think of how many awesome adventures we could have with Link with that formula. And there was a fan-made Zelda game at one point, but it wasn't complete, called Princess of Legend or Legend of Princess, something like that. If anyone watches this can tell me more about that, go ahead and let me know and inbox me or something. It would appear I don't have any fans anymore. I used to have some pretty good turnouts on my streams, but it seems like that's not happening anymore. It's kind of sad. But how the hell am I supposed to do this without getting hit? It's impossible. Unless you have magic. Best strategy I came up or found there is it's better to active hit the laser after it shoots. Because if you do it while it opens up and shoots, you won't be able to hit it in time. Or you can just bypass it altogether. I fucking hate this part. Should be going to Kazuya pretty soon. There's a part where you go up on like an elevator kind of lift thing, and that's the final part, I think, of this stage, which will... Matter of fact, this could be it right here. Yay! This part sucks. It really does. I hate this part. Probably the worst of the stage. But I'll make do with the best I can. This is why I hate it. Yep, this is why I hate this shit right here, is these fucking lasers. And there, I went to play. Oh, I think I start there if memory serves me, though. Yeah. Doesn't matter, though. I still gotta deal with these fucking lasers. They can die in a fire, and I'd be happy. Trying to dodge the lasers. Hopefully I can do it. So far, so good. I don't want to jinx myself, though. That happens far too often. That was impossible. Ugh! No! There. Jeez. Alright, I think we're going to fight what's-his-face now, the last boss of the game. Yes, here he comes. Hopefully I got 2 lives to do it in. Let's do it. Let's do this thing! Now you can actually see him on a proper screen instead of on a piece of shit monitor. Show him the lightning, dude. Save some for people who need electricity. Even though the second form should be coming up in the next couple hits. Maybe one of the most redundant last boss themes, but it's one of the most catchy. I like that on the NES version. So, here we go. I'm probably gonna get killed here. Why do I have to do this again? Fuck this part. It's slow and it's pointless and I hate it, so whatever. to quote my brother here, what a lie. Too bad he wasn't watching. I'd be like, so Mike, was that a lie? He'd be like, yep, that was a lie. If I get hit, I don't care. I get that potion anyways at the top of the... Oh, wow. That was some cool shit. Wow. That was pretty masterful, I must say. That wasn't. Nor was that. But, here we go. That will take care of it. Alright, here we go. Let's try this again. Hopefully I do it, because if not, I'll do the whole stage again. I don't want to do the whole stage again. Yeah, I know I'm whining like a baby, but whatever. I don't care. Second form pisses me off because you can't really... Fucking prick! You can't really tell what fireball's gonna come towards you so you can make the jump. Okay, I'm getting... I'm almost... I'm not going to do well at all here. I am going to have to play the stage over again. So, other viewer, if you're watching, which I can see you are, you're probably better off just watching something else right now, because I'm just going to... You have to watch this whole stage again. And I'm just going to attack this fucker, and hopefully he dies by the time I get killed. And nope. Yep, so unless you want to watch this stage again, stay. But I suggest leaving. Because this is bullshit. And I'm going to remain quiet for the most part because I want to concentrate, because I can't talk and do this at the same time. I'm not good at that. trying to get that bitter taste out of my mouth. I'm still upset about that. That's bullshit. If you want to do good for a stream and show off that you're a decent gamer at best, and then you fail, and it just makes you look like you're a shitty gamer, and it kind of just hits me in a way it shouldn't. So, I mean, I know it's just a game, but I take my gaming seriously. Not as serious as some people out there. Some people take it to the next level. I get kind of upset at myself, because I've been gaming for so long, I shouldn't have died there. I should have won. Well, at least we're making it through the stage at a faster rate, at the very least. Already at the final spot, so that's good. Well, at least you get some good news. I mean, that's a highlight at least. I don't know what I was pulling off there. I just thought, you know what, fuck it. And I did it. Okay, I did that person left. Yeah, I'm gonna get hit here for sure. And I don't. Fucked up. It's like never mind. Nope. Alright, let's try this again, and hopefully this time I win. I'm not gonna hold my breath to it though. Because I'll die. And you know, some people would like that, but I don't think I necessarily would, and I don't think my wife would like that either. I just wish I could have done this as good as I did on that YouTube video. I was just like, bam, done. Well, then again, I am using RetroArch. Arch. Alright, here we go. Final boss fight. Okay, that turned out a little better. Standing too close. Units not doing that. Got it! Good! Fuck you! There's one for the ages. Now you can watch that. I can watch this whole ending scene, listen to this great music and everything in this entirety instead of from a shitty angle. It pretty much copies the ending from Shadow of the Ninja, just to let everyone know. You know, it's a shame that Natsume isn't the strong force that they used to be. If they were the strong force as they used to be, well, it would have been better for them. I don't want to play a game where you gotta constantly pick up cow and horse shit. Okay, I'll shout so you can listen to music. But I just want to say one more thing before I let you guys do that. Is the ending screen, where it says the end, you know, even though it's the creepiest part of a video game, if you ask me, next to a game over screen, don't ask. I don't know why, but most Nintendo games just have a creepy ending screen. This has a pretty good one. I ain't gonna ruin it for you, because I want you to see it, but I'm surprised it passed through censorships of Nintendo. And if you don't know what it is, when it shows, I'll tell you what it is. Okay. The next game I'm probably going to play is going to be on the other channel at Clusterfuckin', because there's no one here watching my shit. So hopefully people at Clusterfuck will. I'm going to do a How Far Can I Get with Streets of Rage 2. And most of the How Far Can I Get that I make on both channels, if I fail, I do revisit those games later on. So, just because I fail doesn't mean I won't revisit it. And if I revisit it and fail, I may just give up. I'm not one of those gamers that just plays a game and plays a game and plays a game until he wins. If I get frustrated and I want to quit, fuck it. Off goes the power switch. Okay, here comes that screen. I'll tell you what it is if you can't guess. You probably can, though. They should have just said the end here. It would have been better, but here. Okay, if you don't know what that is, that's the final boss's head. Yes, it's severed head on the end screen. If it wasn't for the happy music, that shit would give people nightmares. Like Splatterhouse 3, when the game over screen, when you melt, that gave me nightmares. That big old skull with the creepy font in the flames on Risky Woods, that gave me nightmares. It's game over and end screens that always give me the chills. And for some reason, this is no exception. It doesn't give me nightmare notes. Actually, to me, this is more of a happy ending victory, because there's a severed fucking head of the bastard that was giving you problems. I wonder if he's going to take that home and make that his trophy. Of course, that'd be kind of creepy to put your something like that on your wall, and then, you know, there's that anxiety that you think it might move or do something. I don't know. Anyways, this has been a Demonious X playthrough. And I hope you enjoyed it, even though there's no one watching. But if you watch it at a later date, I hope you do enjoy it. I'm going to go ahead and make it another How Far You Can Get on the other channel. So please stay tuned for that. But, you know, no one's watching, so no one got that message. Anyways, this is Demonious X signing off. I thank anyone that's watched or was watching. I'm going to try to put more content on my channel just for the sake of doing so. I'm also trying to help Viking Dave on Clusterfuck get Clusterfuck off the ground. Because it seems like his streamers, no offense to them, just don't care to stream. That's their problem. Anyways, okay, I'm going to shut up now. Alright, have a good night, everyone. Take care of yourselves.